So in the Cities project, we have developed methodology to characterize and integrate energy flexibility. And in this talk, I'm going to tell you about the most fundamental parts in this characterization and integration. So the first crucial observation that we have made is that for all energy flexible systems, that is systems that are able to modulate their consumption, then one fundamental thing is that they all react to some price by changing their demand to something. So in the Cities project, and me coming from a mathematical background notices that, well, in that case we can just consider price as an input and demand as an output, and in that case you can do system identification. So what we proposed was to simply use this system identification to estimate flexibility functions. So these are functions that characterize energy flexibility by predicting demand as a function of price. Okay, and what could this look like? Well, in general, they will look something like this, where if you, as in red, have some step increase in price, then after some delay, tau, you will generally see the demand going down, and then perhaps after a while having a rebound effect to get the system back to the state of charge, the operating point that it was before it started to be flexible. And in this flexibility function, in this figure, you could identify a lot of characteristics that people have done in other studies. They're focused on one of these, but here we have all of them. So for example, you could have the total area, the energy that you can move, C. You could have delta, which is how much can you change the demand in one moment. You could consider eta, the amount of time that you can change the demand. Also, you can look at the rebound effect. You could look at the delay. There's a lot of characteristics, but if you don't consider all of them at the same time, you don't get the full picture of the energy flexibility. But using the flexibility function, you have this dynamic characterization that incorporates all of them. And how can you use this? Well, if you consider how we would like to run our power grids in the future, then we would like to minimize CO2 emissions, for example. So you could imagine that prices, lambda here, should be the CO2 emissions or some function of CO2 emissions. That could be some simple way of doing it. You could also go a little bit more advanced and say that, well, maybe we should use this flexibility function L to make the load follow some reference. Okay, so that we can have more complex things, that maybe we want the reference to be constant so we avoid peaks. Maybe we want the load to follow the wind production. Could be many things. The point is that you can formulate this as an object, as a optimization problem. Okay, so you can find the price that minimizes the difference between expected demand and some reference load. Then what you can do is that you can actually use a hierarchy of controllers. So you could say, well, now we can send this price to each of our flexible systems. And for all of these flexible systems, be it a smart house, a wastewater treatment plant, supermarket, they would all do their own optimization where they just consider price and then they figure out what demand should we have so that we maintain our comfort, efficiency, whatever, but also minimize the costs. And then you could send this price to all the flexible systems you have, right? And they will all do their own optimization problems. And in the end, what you care about is how does this affect the grid, right? How does this cause any problems in the grid? So it's really the solution to each of these optimization problems is sort of sent to the grid because they consume some amount of power. And then when we have done that, we can actually measure this power and close the loop for our overall objective function here, which is designing prices. So we can send it back, update our price to get a new and more accurate demand. And of course, this is not limited to just making the load follow some reference. You could equally well consider that it's the frequency. So maybe you have some function f that gives the frequency as a function of price, then you can also make the frequency follow some reference. And you could even go further and say that, well, we want the voltage. If you have voltage problems in some places, you want the voltage to follow some reference. Or, of course, you could combine all these objectives and have one objective function that minimizes both CO2 emissions, makes the load follow a reference, maybe frequency follow a reference, and the voltage a reference. Then the rest of the framework, all the consumers, they don't have to change a thing. So this is why we believe that the future of the smart operating systems, the smart power system, is to have price-based hierarchical control based on the flexibility function. Thank you.